Now the question becomes, what cover crops do we use? And as I mentioned, we have the legumes such as hairy vetch and crimson clover and Austrian winter peas that fix nitrogen, but they get very little growth in the fall and they're not going to do a lot for soil erosion. What we need to go then are our cereal crops such as cereal rye or triticale or even oats that can overwinter. So we're using those also, and we're using those by themselves or monoculture or in combination. And one of the big issues that farmers have is what's the cost? Because you could get in the $35, $40 per acre very quickly. So one of the things that we're also looking at is what rates do we use, what combinations of the cover crops do we use, and how does that fit what we're trying to do? What we like to do is that we like to plant the corn or the soybeans directly into the cover crop. We modified the planter a little bit by taking out the cultures because they could penetrate that thick mulch a lot better. And I'm really a stickler of wanting good seed to soil contact. So that's why we want to get the seed, whether it's corn or soybeans, into the ground, into moisture. If we're building soil health and we want to look these long-term investments, we will let the cover crop go a little bit more mature. If not, then our recommendation is to terminate the cover crop when it's fairly small in the vegetative stage, but let it help protect the soil during the heavy rains that we get in March and April. Now, once the cash crop like corn or soybeans comes up, it takes a little bit longer in the cover crop, or so it looks, because they have to go through all of that residue, which takes a little bit of time. And our results have shown that soybean yields are fine. Actually, we average about 7 bushel per acre more soybean yield following a cover crop. Now, corn's a little bit different. It really depends on the year and the kind of cover crop that what we're using. Where we do get an increase in corn yield following a cover crop are the dry years. Because what happens is that thick mulch will help conserve moisture. And in those years, we have seen up to a 25 bushel yield increase following a triticale crop, for example.